Hi everybody, it's Danny, and today I have kind of like a review type video, sort of. First off, I want to say like Happy Easter to everybody, because that's when I'm filming this, is after I got back from all my Easter festivities, you know, Easter egg hunts with the kids, dinner with in-laws, stuff like that. And I thought I'd come on, because I actually wore makeup today, and I wore, like, I've been wearing this all day, so that's kind of why it looks like butt. But I figured I'd come on and kind of tell you guys about some of the products I used and what I thought of them. I'm gonna start with my foundation, because I used the Perricone MD No Foundation Serum, and it does not say on the bottle what color is, but I'm pretty sure I got light. I got like the light one, I think. Like the light medium one, like the only color they actually have, I think is the one. I got this on Sephora's website, and this is the travel size bottle. It is 0.3 fluid ounces instead of, what, like a half ounce? So, I actually really liked it. It's a very thin, it's a very thin, like very watery, serum-y foundation, and I love it. It was very light coverage, as you can still see like I have a blemish right here, which obviously it actually kind of got worn away a little bit throughout the day. And like I have a little, like it's not the best coverage, but it is buildable. But something like this is perfect for someone like me who doesn't wear a lot of makeup. Maybe just wants a little coverage to kind of maybe even out the skin tone a little bit. Or just, you know, on where I do feel like looking a little, you know, where I do feel like wearing makeup, I just want a little bit, you know? And I really do like this. And it does have broad spectrum SPF of 30. And if I remember correctly, I think the Perricone MD line has anti-aging stuff in it. But it doesn't say on the bottle. I thought it did, but I can't be for sure. You know what I mean? Like, I thought I heard that, but I might be thinking of a different brand. I don't remember. But I really do like it. And if I were to use this bottle up, I would buy another one. I don't think I'd ever buy a full size. Or no, I think full size is a whole ounce, not a half an ounce, a whole ounce. But I don't think I'd ever buy a full size, just because a full size is like $60. I would just probably just keep buying this, since I don't wear makeup that often. One of these will last me forever. So, but if I were to ever use this up completely, based on like the first impressions I've had of it, I would definitely buy another one. Now we'll go on to like what I have on my lips. Is this by Bite Beauty, and it is a matte cream lip crayon in the color, I think it's called Gavi, G-A-V-I, and I bought this a couple years ago, around, like, after Christmas time. It was, like, in their little mix and mingles type thing. It was, like, the little ones that are only, like, $10 and $12. It's not the mix and mingle, because it only has one color, and like the mix and mingles are the two. But this was like a mini, like travel size one. And this is how much product I have left out of it. I've been using it a lot lately, and I love Bite Beauty lipsticks. I have quite a few of the mix and mingles, and then I have this one, and then I do have their agave lip mask, which I really do like as well. And yes, I really, really like this a lot. I've been wearing it a lot lately, actually. They're super creamy, and they don't feel like super gross on the lips. And when you lick your lips, at least this one has a pleasant taste. Like, it doesn't taste like weird lipstick taste, how sometimes lipsticks can taste like kind of funny. This one has like like a really pleasant sweet taste. It doesn't really taste like anything like in particular like vanilla or anything. It just has like a pleasant sweet taste to where licking your lips is not extremely unpleasant. So if you can find this, I would definitely buy it. Like if I tried when I first bought this to find this in a full size and I didn't see it, but they might make it again. I don't know. But if you haven't tried Bite, I do suggest trying their lipsticks because they are pretty dang cool and they're pretty amazing, and everything is, I think, food grade. I think, if I remember correctly, everything is like food grade and made with all natural stuff that isn't going to hurt you. Like, no, there's no weird chemicals like some nail, I almost said nail polishes, like some lipsticks. Please do not put nail polish on your face or mouth. The next thing I'm going to talk about is this mascara, because I'm wearing it today, and this is the NARS Audacious Mascara, and it is in the color Black Moon, and I got this a couple of months ago, around Christmassy time from Sephora, because I made an order, and they were having, like, these, like, if you bought $25 or more, you could use a code. It's obviously not active anymore, but where you could put in the code and get like these, you could pick between like 5 or 6 like really cool goodie bags, and this was in my goodie bag, and it is awesome. And I think it was in there, I think it had just like came out. I love the brush. Like, it's really spiky and synthetic, and they're all different like lengths. Like, if you look like this line, like, it's got a long one and then it's got a short one next to it, and it made my lashes look really good. I really, really enjoyed it. Well, let me kind of bring you guys closer and see if you guys can look. Like that, they look really good. They're not like spiky, they're not weird. I do have it on my bottom lashes as well, just very, very lightly. And I just really like it. I didn't line my top lid, because I never do. But, like, it looks really good and full. And I don't know, I just really like it. And there's the lipstick. The last thing is what I'm wearing on my eyes. I'm not showing you guys my eyeliner, because I just use a basic black Lord & Barry eyeliner. It's just an itty-bitty little sample size that I got in a Ipsy bag, like, forever ago, and it's only, like, that big. I use it all the time. But, what I used on my eyes, and I didn't really do a lot to my eyes. I went for a very light, natural, I didn't really do much of anything. I just wanted a little bit of something. I used the Wonderful Dreams palette by Sephora. They came out with this around Christmas time. I got mine like a month or two ago, and this was a $10 palette, which was an amazing price by itself, but I got it on sale for $7, and I don't know if there's any left, so, but it opens like this, and it has 8 shadows in it, and I only used 2, actually, because, again, I was just going for a very simple look. I didn't want to, you know, do anything too super like hardcore, because I'm not very good at makeup. Like, really? I mean, I'm not wearing blush. I don't highlight. I don't contour. I don't wear blush. I barely wear foundation. Yeah, I'm pretty much a lipstick and eyeliner person. I don't even really venture too hardcore into the eyeshadows, because I'm not that good at it either. But I put this color right here, which is Soft Cookie, all over my lid. And then I took this color, which is Pretty Sunrise. My camera's going funny. I think it's because the packaging is pink. Everything went kind of pink for a minute, didn't it? But I took this color right here, this really glittery, called Pretty Sunrise. And I put that all over my inner corner. Like, I put Soft Cookie all over, and then I just took that nice glittery shade and I just put it right there and kind of blended it in. And if I bring you guys in a little bit, you can see, like, I still have a bunch of the glitter and, like, the color is still kind of there, but, like, it was a really light color, so you couldn't really, it just made it slightly. But there is a ton of fallout underneath my eye. You can see it, like, when I bring you close, you can really see the glitter. And you can really see it, like, if I go outside, like, in the light. But, like, just, like, me looking in a mirror, like, I can see it, but not very well. But, like, you can see there's a lot of glitter fallout from that color. So keep that in mind if you have this palette and you haven't used it yet, or if you wanted to get it and you can still find it, because I don't know if they still have any on the website, and I don't know about in stores, but Pretty Sunrise has a fuck ton of fallout. I can't say anything about the other shimmery shades like Crystal Ball, Toasted Almond, or Chantilly Lace. I don't know if those ones have fallout because I have not used them yet, but Pretty Sunrise has a hella lot of fallout. And that is what I'm wearing on my face, and, you know, what I did and kind of what I think. I actually really do like this palette, especially, like, again, the only matte shade I've used is Soft Cookie, and again, but that one I thought performed very well. You know, based on swatches, I think my least favorite color is going to be Midnight Swim, and that's just this weird dark blue, like green blue. I don't think I'll ever use it, but I really do think I'll use the rest of the palette a lot. I can see myself reaching for this again, like, a bunch, even though Pretty Sunrise had so much fallout. I can still see myself using it, you know, again, and I do really like it. And again, and this packaging is just so freaking cute. So yeah, that is my video, just showing you what I did. And if you guys have any comments, you know, leave them down below. Any tips, tricks, you know, what I can try next time, maybe what I did wrong this time, you know, things like that. Just let me know, and I will talk to everyone later. Bye.